Praise the Lord.
Abooluganda mukama ayebazibwe.
Brethren, praise the Lord.
Erinnya lyange.
My name.
Nze Esther Teo Nalunkuuma.
Is Esther Teo Nalunkuuma.
Ngandi musomesa wabatini wano ku Gospel Messenger.
And I am a teacher of the teens class.
Omulamwa ogwatuwebwa okuva guno mwaka we gwatandika tubadde tutambulira ku mulamwa.
The theme that was given to us since this year began, we've been working in the theme that says,
tukirizo kubanga tukolachi, tutambulira mitendera.
That we should accept the process.
Tutambulira mitendera.
Accepting the process.
Accepting the process.
Okutambulira mitendera.
Refers to opening up.
Chigenda mukubikulirwa.
To the reality of things. And agreeing to take a journey.
Era okukkiriza okutandika olugendo.
Or steps.
Oba ebigenda maaso.
Under someone.
Ng'oli wansi w'omuntu.
For example, a teacher.
Okutwaliza wamu ng'omusomesa.
A mentor.
Omuyigiriza.
A pastor.
Omusumba.
Parents.
Omuzadde.
And God.
Ne Katonda.
So as to learn,
okusobola okuyiga,
and avoid premature growth,
n'okwewala okukula nga tonnatuuka,
thereby achieving a particular result, goal or vision.
N'osobola okutuukiriza ebiruumirirwa byo n'ebirooto.
Abooluganda mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Abooluganda mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Tukirize tutambulire mutendera.
Let us accept the process.
I'm
going to be talking about price.
The
price that one needs to accept the
process.
Accepting the process is not something
easy. But
the Holy Spirit helps us.
Awo wakati ekisooka kye ngenda okwogerako, ngenda kwogera ebintu mwenda naye nga mbitemamu.
I'm going to speak about 9 things, but I'm going to divide them into 3.
Ekisooka wabeerawo okubonaabona kw'oyitamu okw'akaseera.
First of all, there are sufferings and tribulations that we go through for a certain time.
Naye kino kikuleetera okuba ng'oyiga okuba ng'ogumiikiriza.
But this teaches us that we should be patient.
Mu kugumiikiriza togenda kuba ng'ogumiikiriza ng'otudde butuzi wansi.
As you are being patient, you're not going just to sit on yourself.
Naye ogenda kwetaaga okuba ng'osaba obutakoowa.
But you're going to need to be prayerful and seasonally.
Mu kitabo kya Samweri ekisooka.
In the book of Samuel.
Esula esooka olunyiriri olw'okubiri.
In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 2, from verse 1 and the following verses, we see a woman, her name was called Hannah. And the other was called
Penina.
They had a husband, and the name of the husband was Elkanah.
Kana yali mukyala omugumba.
Hannah was a barren woman.
Ganewankubadde yayagalibwa nnyo bba.
But she was most loved by the husband.
Naye nga kye yali ayitamu ng'okubonaabona kwali kuba nti yali mugumba.
But what she was going through as in the period of suffering was being barren.
Penina mukama yali yamuwa omukisa nga kumpi ye buli mwaka azaala.
Penina had been blessed by the Lord, and each and every year she was giving birth.
Elkana yaina enono gye yali ng'atambuliramu.
Elkana was moving through a process, and
buli mwaka yagendanga ku lusozi esiro.
Each and every year he used to move to a mountain. He used to move to a mountain called Shiloh.
N'agenda n'asinza omutonzi we.
And he went to worship the Lord.
Oluvanyuma n'awaayo saddaka.
And then he gave his offering.
We yamala okuwaayo saddaka yakomangawo ewaka n'awa Penina omugabo gwe.
After offering the sacrifice, he used to come back home and give each and every one in his household what belonged to them. And because Hannah had no child, but she was the most loved, he used to give Hannah two shares. Because of the love that he had towards Hannah. After Penina getting a lot of the shares that she and her children had received, then she used to go to Hannah to brag around. She used to say hurting words. She used to tell her words that could hurt her so much that Hannah reached an extent of crying. But his husband always used to comfort her, but Hannah refused to stop crying. She reached an extent of not eating because of the pain she was going through. But she never stopped there. She was so patient. And she decided to go into the house of the Lord. And she cried to the Lord. There is a time that came and she cried. She cried and she looked like someone who was drunk. She was praying to the Lord from the bottom of her heart. She lay down before the Lord and presented her. During that time, other people who were praying so loudly. But Eli, the prophet of the Lord, looked at Hannah while she was praying. And he saw Hannah praying, seeing her lips moving, and she asked, and he asked her, "Why are you drunk in the house of the Lord?" The reason as to why Eli came and asked Hannah why she was drunk is because he saw her praying abnormally. But Hannah was going through a lot. And she had been so patient. And she had no one to tell her problems because everyone around her used to laugh at her. Take an example of you being married and you'd spend 5 years in marriage without having a child. The people around you will always tell you hurting words. But truth be told, you are going through a certain process, but that process is so painful. And the others cannot comprehend it. And during prayer, Hannah promised the Lord that if he had granted him a son, that she would offer the child to worship the Lord all the days of his life.
nga wayiseewo ekiseera nga Eli amaze okumugamba nti osobola okuddayo mirembe.
After Eli had told her that she could go back in peace,
Mukama agenda kuddamu essaala ye, naye yakkiriza.
That God would answer her prayers.
Koro yali akummere.
That day she ate.
We yali emmere. Era neyebaka n'omwami we nga bulijjo.
And she ate some food and went along to sleep with her husband.
Waitawe banga.
After some time,
Kana naweba omwana Samuel.
Hannah conceived and got a child Samuel.
Inamtuma Samuel.
And named him Samuel.
Kubanga Katonda yali amuwadde.
Because God had granted her.
Ngawe yali ennono ya Elukana. Era omwaka gwayitawo.
As it was Elkanah's habit to go to the mountain, he went to the mountain and worshipped and gave in his sacrifices.
Hannah
did not go with his husband because he had made a promise to the Lord.
Rokubo mwana yali muto budde bwayitanga mwana amaze okuva ku mabeere ndowooza wano bayonsa mpaka emyaka nga ebiri.
After 2 years of breastfeeding the child,
omwana n'amutwala musinzizo oba muyeeka.
She took the child to the house of the Lord.
N'amutwala muyeekaalo bambi n'akkiriza okuba ng'ayita mu mutendera ogw'okuba nga tagenda kulabirira mwana we, kumulaba ng'atambula, kumulaba ng'akola kino, akola kiri, avubuka.
And she accepted the process of believing that she could not raise her child. And she offered the child to God as she had promised. And because she had accepted the process, we see that Samuel was the first prophet in Israel.
Ye yasoko okubanga afuka kama futa kabake yasoko era mu Isirayiri.
He was the first one to pour anointing onto the first king in Israel.
Ne kabaka fena fena gwe tumanyi Daudi era yali Samweli.
And to the first king that we all know, King David, it was Samuel who anointed him. Because her mother had accepted the process of suffering and being patient to wait upon the Lord. The other value that I want to talk about, there is hard working.
N'okubanga emirembe gyo byoyagala okukola ebimu ogenda kubanga oteekeddwa obivaako.
And leaving your comfort zone aside.
Then newabayo n'okumalirira.
But there is also being determined.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Kakati twogedde kukola ennyo.
We have talked about working hard and getting out of your comfort zone and being determined. Here I'm going to talk about myself. As I was starting my university, I had nothing. My tuition had not yet been paid. I went to university. I had no book. And then I got a 48-page book. And I got a small bag. But because I had something that I wanted to achieve, I had to work hard. Because I never wanted to leave out the money of my parents. I started studying. But I don't want to tell you that studying was something easy. The process was so hard.
But
they used to give me money.
But
the money at times wasn't enough. Because I was studying from a place distant from home. I used to budget for my money. I used to budget for transport and coursework. I used to budget for eating, but at times I used to forego eating and take some water. But they used to ask me how much I needed. And I made a budget and gave it to them. But they used to tell me that the money was too much. I think you are stealing our money. I was schooling from Chambogo. And I was coming from home. I was coming from Machinje Lusaka. But because there is something that I wanted, at times, I used to forego eating. I never had a laptop. I never used to have that luxury life that everyone needs. But I had to study. I had started my first semester in the second year. I started studying in
2019.
You all remember that in 2019 it is when COVID started. But they had not yet closed up our university.
So in Nalimu second year.
So while I was in my second year, they closed up. And I was so patient. I thought it was just for a certain time. But we all know what happened next. They always kept on postponing everything. They kept on adding more days. And I came and it came a time when I asked myself, why am I striving so hard with education? While I was in my vacation, I used to work. When COVID-19 was almost coming to one end, when they had started releasing some things, I started looking for jobs. But the devil is a liar. And at times a time came when I had to decide upon either working or going back to school. But I also needed the money. I sat down and cried. I cried and I sat down and asked myself, I really need this job, but then a time will come when I also need my academic documents. And I made a choice to leave aside the job and go back for my studies. I want to thank the Lord that I accomplished my education.
A bachelor's degree.
And now I have a bachelor's degree in community development and social justice. I want to thank everyone who stood by my side, everyone who comforted me, everyone who prayed for me. May the Lord bless you.
But I'm...
I But I wouldn't have achieved all that I was wishing to achieve if at all I had not accepted the process. And leaving that aside, they had not yet graduated us.
Expired courses.
And they told us about the expired courses. We were waiting for us to be graduated, and then they're telling us that the courses we took are expired. I called my friends and I just laughed. And then I asked them, will they graduate us or not? But then if they graduate us in expired courses, what about when we go to ask for the jobs? I ask myself, when they chase us because the courses are expired.
Nengamba kale tugume na yenga mazima tebyali expired. Just National Council of Higher Education ye ayina okwetereza eddemo okubanga ekolachi.
But truth be told, the courses were not expired. It was just a problem within the National Council. But I thank the Lord because that also was done. The other value that we have to pay. There is observing carefully the commandments that have been given to you.
Then also okubango nonya bichi ebitufu ebyokusoma.
And there is also looking for what exactly you are supposed to read. And surrounding yourself with the right company. We all have role models in our lives. All people that we look unto. But sometimes we look at people that we just don't know, people that we see on television and social media.
Radio.
Or you just hear about them on the radio.
Mukama ebazi.
Praise the Lord.
Ono omuntu golabirako omwetaaga nga wabuliwo osobola omutuukako n'omwebuuzaako singa wabeera wabaddewo ekibaddewo.
Your role model should be that person that you can easily access.
Si kubeera na muntu mbu role model wange ye TDJX.
Not having someone as your role model and you don't know about their whereabouts.
Tetuganye yes mulungi.
We don't want to say that TD Jakes is a bad person.
Mulungi na ye. Tosobola mutuukirira singa oba olina ky'oyagala okumwebuuza.
He is a very good person but you cannot easily access him if you want to ask something from him.
Shovola bafena fena batugambo bela ne kanisa.
That is the reason as to why they always tell us to have a home church. Just like everyone has their household. Your paternal auntie's place is not your home. And your uncle's place is not your home. At the end of it all, your parents' home is your home. And to the marriage, you have to go back to your husband or your wife's home.
Wano nabagambye tugezeko okubanga tunonya ebintu ebitufu ebyokusoma.
I've always told you that we should seek the right information to read.
Mukanisa tuine ekitabo ekitukuvu.
In the church we have the Holy Bible.
Nayo kisoma emirundi emeka mu wiki.
But how often do you read your Bible?
Wonaga ano kisoma.
If you refuse to read the Bible,
toja kula.
You won't grow.
Omutendera gukulemyo yitam toja guitam.
The process has failed you. Because here within our midst, we have people that have jumped some processes. When you ask them to open the book of Matthew, you find them in the Old Testament. Because they missed a certain process. And you might find yourself that they had missed the stage of being in Sunday school. While we were in Sunday school, they used to make us read the Bible each and every day. Because we wanted to grow.
Naye gwe weekube mu mutima, olabe ebyomwoyo, emitendera gy'omwoyo, ogenda najyo maaso, oba oli muntu ali awo naga naga.
You should sit down and ask yourself, are you going on with the spiritual things or you're just there?
Mukama yebazibwa.
Praise the Lord.
Abooluganda mukama yebazibwa.
Amen.
Mbaboa.
Am I boring?
But
let us accept the process. And also following the specific instructions that have been given to us. I was talking about role models. When we read from the Bible, Timothy had Paul. And he is the one who mentored him into being a good preacher. In 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 12. It tells us not to despise us because of our youth. Let no one despise you. They might not be talking about your youth as in your youth. But there are people who can despise you because of your age. Because of your character. And you are that kind of... They always tell us that people that are old are always wise. But you mean that people that are foolish do not grow old. So we have to know that not every old or aged person can
Kubanga
be inquired
for.
Because there are those that have jumped the process. We have seen our fathers. They have pot bellies. But they're on TikTok dancing weird. TikTok is not bad, but they jumped a certain process. So at this particular moment, they do not have to be showcasing that talent. There are people that are aged.
Naenga enviri za sala olabira dalanga oba omuchini ye yandibadde akole ebyo ne tumaya amyako yo jeji musungu.
But when you look at their hairstyle, it does not suit their age.
Kubanga tulina akaseera kabuvubukanga akusumbua.
Because we have a certain time that comes for us.
Naeno sango omukaddenga naye asaze chimeme.
But then you look at the old people that are grown up.
Having red hair.
When you look at such people, do not blame them because they have not accepted such a process. So let us accept the process. You find grown-up women putting on short dresses like for babies. The cleavage is out. When they try bending down, you tell them to choose to leave the things down. Then you should know that that person has
choice.
It might be because of their parents.
It
might be because of their parents that they had failed to mentor them. They
could
And just because they have got the freedom and the liberty to do whatever they want, they want to disguise us.
Naye nga wadde ngamba nti n'abavubuka atusumbwa n'abavubuka era tebakkirizibwa kubanga bakola ebintu ebimu.
But even though we are talking to the old women that have jumped the processes, even the processes such as bad examples should not be done by the
okulira otya mu kanisa nawe n'otugamba era oyambala akagoye konna kakutippye kyokka kakoma eno.
How can you be raised up by the church and you also start putting on short dresses?
Kyokka obuzibu nga bunadda ku bunnaabwo olwo ne balyoka bamwaniriza ajjabeeko ne kyatugamba katuuta.
And then they welcome you to come and say something on the pulpit.
Yandibanga byayogera byamagezi.
You might be talking sense.
Naye abali wano mwena mwena temugenda kubanga mutegeeramu n'ekyo.
But then everyone looking at you won't understand.
Kubanga ebirowoozo byonna bigenda kubeera ku lugoye lwayamba.
Because the mindset of the people that you're speaking to will be
ate obeera wano maaso nga teweegendereza nga akagoye kakutte bulungi okomekerera oli bw'oti.
And then you start pulling down the dress.
Kama yebazibwa ab'oluganda.
Praise the Lord.
Wewebika wenawe natowera. Buli lugoye luyina gye lulaga. Manya engoye zijja mu kanisa.
Muvubuka gwe
tewetaaga kubanga ojja ng'osibye balansi.
Ng'ate ojja mu kanisa.
Tewetaaga kujja ng'ate oyambadde damage simanya accident ekoma eno.
You do not need to put on the damaged clothes as you're coming to church.
Ekoma eno n'akapale ak'omunda wano tunaatera okukalengera. Naye naawe olagoze mu kanisa. Bible tugamba jangu nga woli.
The Bible tells us to come as
naye tuongerako. Ate tokkiriza kusigala nga we wazze. Beera n'okukyusibwakyusibwa.
Do not accept to remain the way you are.
Si bintu byakubanga oli bize osinza. Mukama, buyimba. Tukusinza, tukutenda, naye nga amazima. Naye wenyini nyini agamba tukusinza, tukulanga ebirowoozo tebiri wano.
You should always set your mind on what you are saying.
Bible we kugamba mbwa enonya abamusinza moyo namazima.
When the Bible tells us that God is looking for those that can worship in truth and in spirit.
Bana emusinze moyo namazima.
Let us worship the Lord.
Siku sinzo lokuba waliwo camera.
Don't worship him because there are cameras.
No belao. Tugulumize mukama jukira katinga super Sunday. Waliwo roberao. Kamera nejja nekutunula munnyo naye nga amazima oba ebirowoozo bibaddewa n'otandika okuba tugulumize amaaso wootemereza wookolaki awo teweewaddeeyo fe wano wa kamera ayinza okulaba wano naba bannanga omwana asinza n'alemeza nawo naye nga amazima oli wali oba owa kamera avaawo ddi.
Do not worship the Lord because of the people that are around you.
Oh, you know, mutendera go wabuka.
You jumped a certain.
Wano mukanisa tetudda mukwega. Banaye muyimuse mikono ngaye bakola mu Sunday school. Sunday school banaye wetuba tusinza muzibirize kumaso. Muanike mikono waggulu. Eno tetubyogera.
Here in church we do not command people to raise their hands. Wobo mutendera go obuse
wabera wakasera nga tosobola gudda.
If at all you skipped a certain stage.
Naye kyekiri kye nabagambye.
But this is what I've told you.
Ntibera kone gwolabirako bagwe webuzaako.
That have a role model.
Naye sikubera noyo gwe webuzaako ngaate omuntu tosobola mutuukirira.
But then your role model should be someone that you can easily access.
Tuyina abasumba baffe wano tebaliko security, tebaliko police.
We have our pastors.
Tebeta agakola appointment mpanvu nnyo noyita protocol
nnyo. They do not have bodyguards. You do not need a lot of.
Babeerawo ku kkanisa oba olina omutendera gwe wabuuka osobola okugenda n'omwebuuzaako.
Our pastors are always available. You can always
woba otidde omusumba.
If at all you're fearing the pastors.
Osobola okuddayo n'obuuza maybe ku basomesa b'abavubuka oba ababatiini oba aba Sunday school. Tebajja kugoba.
You can inquire from the different teachers that we have here at church.
Bible egamba we munankwatibwa ensonyi.
The Bible says that that if you are ashamed of me in front of
nange
the people,
I will
also be ashamed of you in the eyes of my Father. So let the things of God.
Woba olina omutendera gwe wabuuka nga wenna bagambye tunoonye ebitugasa oba like seek the right information.
Woba olina omutendera gwe wabuuka noonya amateeka amatuufu agogoberera.
Soma nyo butabo.
Read novels.
Soma mawulire.
Read the newspapers.
Soma ebyawandikibwa.
Read the scriptures.
Woba tomanyi kusoma kusaba bwebuze ku moyo mutuku.
If at all you don't know how soma to pray, Bible ibuli chimu cho
nacho namo chewetaga mo echiri.
Everything you need to go through Hallelujah. This life.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ngamaliriza.
As I conclude.
Zaburi asatu musanvu tano.
Psalms chapter 37 and verse 5.
Zaburi asatu musanvu tano.
Psalms 37, 5. It says, Commit your way to the Lord. Trust also in Him, and He shall bring it to pass.
Olugendo lwo olisingirizanga oluyigirizanga
oluyingirisizenga
olunyigisanga kigambo kinemye kiwamba
oluyiringisizenga
oluyiringisizenga mukama era wesiga oyo naye anakituukiriza. Version y'oluzungu gye nasomye tugamba commit your way to the Lord.
The Bible that I read says commit your way to the Lord.
Wali ekigambo ekirala kye tusobola okukozesa okusinga oluyiringisizanga.
Luteke maaso
ga Mukama. Ya, olugendo lwo luteke maaso ga Mukama.
Commit your way to the Lord.
Woba okedde ku makya.
If at all you wake up in the
morning. Sabako si bintu byakubanga okera bukezi n'ozuka buzukusi n'okola by'oyina okukola. Tosabye nako n'otambula butambuzi.
Set aside some time to pray before you leave your household.
Mwebaze kubanga alukeseza omugambo olugendo lwange olunaku olwaleero ndukukwasizza. Jangu ombeere ompe omukisa. Okitegeera.
Bless the Lord for what He has done and commit everything you're going to do that day to the Lord. Commit yourself to the Lord. Galatians chapter 6 and verse 9.
Abaluganda mukama ebaze.
Praise the Lord. Galatians chapter 6 and verse 9.
Batugamba obutaku.
The Bible tells us
tulemenga kulindiriranga okuddiriranga mukolo obulungi kubanga ebiro birituuka.
And let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart.
Tuli kungulanga.
We shall reap.
Tuli kungulanga nga tuzi. Tuli kungula. Nga tetuzirise. Tuli kungulanga nga tetuzirise.
We shall reap if at all we don't lose heart.
Bamikwano temukowa kola bulungi.
Brethren, do not get weary in doing good. Do not get weary in doing good. Even though in the journey there are a lot of challenges, let us not grow weary in doing good.
Tweyongere okubanga tuyita mitendera mukama bawo omukisa.
Let us always accept the process. May the Lord bless you.